Good morning and happy Halloween. So, finally Halloween. And I love Halloween. I always have this year. It hasn't felt, it hasn't felt quite as like festive. I cut my fringe. I'm not sure how I feel about it. But anyway. I know. I see you. Can you sit down and eat your food? But I went to speech therapy this morning, and Milo and Ivy got to wear their costumes. Ivy doesn't go to speech therapy, but I don't know how I feel about this. I feel like I look like Urkel. But anyway, yeah, Ivy doesn't go, but she comes with us. So she wore her ballerina costume, and Milo wore his Optimus Prime Transformer costume. So it was really fun. Them getting to dress up already, and now it's lunchtime. So the kids are having corn dogs, pretzels, and pear slices, and yeah, Penelope has an early release day today, so I'm gonna go get her here in about like 20-30 minutes, and we're gonna keep on with our Halloween-y day. I do need to show you guys what we're having for dinner though, and also this is my morning outfit, which is my Halloween Horror Nights 2022 shirt. So I got this year before the event, and it says every day is Halloween. So it's got a 31 and just like some spooky classic characters, and on the back it says Halloween Horror Nights 2022. So that's what I wore today with one of my skorts to speech therapy and just some sneakers. And I got a skeleton onesie to wear for Halloween, but I put it on this morning, and because my thighs are so big, it makes so the like thigh bone, or like, you know, what's this, our femur? The leg bones are like on the inside of my legs because of the way my legs rub together. So that's kind of funny. We'll see. I might change to be like a mummy with some curtains that we have laid out there, but we'll see how much time I have. Here's how the pumpkin seeds turned out. So I did olive oil spray. They look kind of burnt, but they're not. They don't taste burnt at all. But I did olive oil spray, and then I'll show you the seasonings that I used. So I used this paleo pink powder, which is just like an everything seasoning. And then I used some pink Himalayan sea salt, and then some Cuban style citrusy garlic seasoning blend from, did I say Trader Joe's? From Trader Joe's. And that's, oh, and then the olive oil spray was that one right there. And that's what was on these. Oh, and then I'll show you guys, a slice of the pumpkin pie. Not pumpkin pie, goodness, pumpkin loaf. Oh, spooky Milo. Ooh. So here is our pumpkin loaf. So I made this with, so I used just like a traditional pumpkin loaf recipe, but I didn't have enough regular flour. So I used a 2-to-1 ratio, is that what it's called, of regular flour and then almond flour. So it called for 3.5 cups of regular flour. I used 2 cups almond flour, 1.5 cup, right, I think, of regular flour. And then instead of vegetable oil, I used coconut oil, and I used 3/4 cup instead of a full cup. And it is super moist. It's very dense. It's just, it's so good, you guys. Like, it might be the best pumpkin loaf I've ever made. And it made 2 loaves. So I did one of them without pecans, because like kids are picky, and then one of them with pecans, but only like a handful. And when Penelope tried it, she was like, I wanted more pecans. But it's really good. I'll link the recipe in case you want to try it. It's not my recipe, but it's really good. Here is the loaf. See, doesn't that look so nice? It's all cooked, but it's like, it's so moist, honestly. And I don't like that word, but I don't think this could probably last more than a couple of days though, because it is so moist. So I went ahead and put the other one in our fridge, but oh yeah, that's good stuff. That's it's honestly gonna be my lunch with a coffee. Oh, and I definitely forgot to show you guys the pumpkins, how they all turned out. This is Penelope's. She got a ghost that says boo. Here's Milo's, just like a jack-o'-lantern face. And then here's Ivy's. So I want to say it's Ivy. She just picked out the design. I carved it, but I definitely messed up and it like popped off. So that's why it's kind of taped. So it looks cooler when it's all lit up. I'll insert a clip of what I posted on Instagram, I think. But Penelope made a sign that says take one or else. Then she did a creepy clown, a Frankenstein, and a one-eyed jack-o'-lantern. That was so funny. Mister, you ready for Halloween? He says, no. Are you? No?
That freaked me out.
What did? Why are you taking off your shoes already?
Yeah, it's all my poison.
No, it doesn't. All right, so dinner tonight is gonna be these pumpkin and bat ravioli. It's just got cheese inside. But these are the shapes of little pumpkins, little bats. Those are just so cute. I think we got these either from Costco or Sam's Club. And they're just adorable. I've been saving them for Halloween. Yep. You want to see them? It's pasta. And then we're going to make a pink sauce to go with it.
What pink sauce?
It's going to be a pink pasta sauce. With the rest of our favorite marinara and a little dash of heavy cream. Oh, you need to wash your hands? Okay. You got pickle juice on them? Milo just woke up from his nap, so he's feeling a little crabby and sleepy. So dinner didn't go down as well with this one. She just didn't care for it. Yeah, it's a diaper. Anyway, they're playing right now, and we have about an hour until trick-or-treating starts. So we'll probably start, I'm going to start going ahead and like doing my makeup and getting my costume together. And then after that, I'll start getting the kids dressed, and probably by the time 6 o'clock rolls around and trick-or-treating starts, we'll be ready to go. And I was totally sent this Naked palette, which is the Naked by Robin Eisenberg palette, and it is stunning. And this is what I've used for my makeup today. So this was my everyday Halloween look. And this has got to be the most gorgeous palette, I think, ever that Naked has come out with. So you can guess which two colors I used. And since I'm going for Egyptian mummy tonight, I think I'm gonna be going for the colors Ion, which is that gold one, and then maybe one of the deeper blues for my makeup for taking the kids trick-or-treating as a mummy. And I'm gonna tell you after I get into my costume what my costume is made out of. All right, happy Halloween. So this is our costume for the night. We're doing skeleton onesie, and it's kind of killing me because this is not an anatomically correct skeleton, but I still enjoy it. And there's my booty.
Are you guys excited?
Can we wait here for a few
seconds? Yeah, we can. It's not quite trick-or-treat time.
And people usually start at like 6:15.
Oh, okay. Fashionably late.
No. Not. But they have to get it down.
Did you get some candy, buddy?
Yeah?
Oh, it's just the daddy going with his kids.
Ah! Mommy, witches are there.
Oh, witches? Must mean there's good candy. You want me to open that, buddy?
That's right. Uh oh, that wouldn't be good.
Layla's got his eye on the prize for this freshly popped popcorn.
Oh, yeah, that guy is scary.
You can get one. Yeah. This is what we call the zombie house when we walk by it on our walks. They go all out. They even did a little mini Halloween Horror Nights over there. It was like a little spooky house.
It's all dark and my lipstick is crazy, but we had a really fun night trick-or-treating, and I'm gonna go ahead and cut to this right away. I decided to trust the honesty policy with our candy, and I set it out. I'll include pictures. I set it out on the kind of like on the sidewalk in front of our house. And I set it on a table with a nice Halloween tablecloth and the jack-o'-lanterns that we carved around it. And then Penelope made that little sign that said, just take one piece, please. And yeah, somebody stole our candy bucket. So that was really disappointing because the whole time Penelope was like, ooh, when I'm gonna get back, when we get back to the house, I'm gonna hand out the rest of the candy. And then when we got back to the house, Penelope was like, did you forget to put out the candy bucket? I was like, no, I put it out. And then, yeah, somebody stole it. And I posted on our community Facebook page. I was like, hey, if anybody gets home and notices that they have, like, a green candy bucket that's not theirs, like, if you could just return it to us. No questions asked. Like, my kids are just devastated because, like, Ivy burst out crying. Penelope was so sad. And I was just like, oh my gosh, like this is not a fun way to end the night trick-or-treating. It kind of put a damper on the rest of the evening, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I kept telling the kids, I was like, all whoever took it obviously needed it way more than we did. And then when I, because Penelope was like, oh, check the doorbell, because we have a doorbell cam, she was like, check the doorbell. And I checked it because I was like, okay, you know, it's all right. You know, they just needed it more than we did. But yeah, I checked it and I was really hoping it was like some teenager that grabbed the bucket, you know, like being like a smart teenager and grabbed the bucket, you know, thinking they were cool. No, somebody in a pickup truck, like a dark pickup truck, pulled up in front of the house, grabbed the candy bucket, got back in the driver's seat, drove away. I kid you not. I was like, seriously? An adult took our empty candy bucket? Like, really? So, I don't know. But I don't think I'm going to tell Penelope because she's, like, she gets so, she takes all that really seriously. My hair, I don't know what to do about it. But yeah, the kids got a lot of candy though. Like, we still got 3 full bags. It's just kind of that somebody stole that. It's not cool to steal, kids. Just don't steal. Like, even when you're an adult, don't steal. It's not cool. It's not fun for anybody. Just don't do it. Anyway, I'm gonna go take a shower and get all clean and stuff. And I guess I'll probably sign off then. That way it's a little bit better lighting. But I just wanted to explain to you guys. And I'm like, I'm still in my costume. And it was super hot. It was probably like 80 degrees and super humid tonight trick-or-treating. And we walked around the whole neighborhood. So yeah, I need to wash my hair and everything. So I will talk to you guys in just a little bit. But hopefully nobody stole your candy bucket. I hope they didn't, guys. That's just... Don't steal anybody else's candy buckets either. Don't do it. All right, I'm all fresh-faced. My hair is washed and officially put up for the night. But I just went and checked on the kids. They're all snoozing peacefully. No sign of my green bucket yet because I checked the doorbell camera to see if maybe anybody like sneakily returned the trick. No. I have a feeling that candy bucket's gone. So the saga
of the green candy bucket is over. I think we've had that one for almost 9 years. That was like the very first one we got when Zach and I had our first house there in Georgia on base, and Penelope was a newborn. Yeah, so 'tis over. So now I'm just gonna take my Mary Ruth magnesium, which, so I'm pretty sure I used to be a Mary Ruth partner. Like, I did all the content for them and stuff, but they, like, I emailed them because I missed one when the hurricane hit and I had to evacuate. I missed like a content, like a post, but then I ended up posting, I think about 2 weeks later with content. I think it was about the hair, skin, and nail gummies, which honestly are amazing. Like, if you've noticed, my hair has grown out like exponentially. It has. Like, I have full-on mermaid hair just after taking those for like 6 weeks, and it's a 2-month supply, I believe, in the bottles. I don't know if that applies to all bottles, but it's with the magnesium, and I'm pretty sure it's with the hair, skin, and nails. I swear. And like, so whenever I got my Gel X nails taken off, and like, anytime you have something on your nails, it's always really hard on them. But I got them taken off, and this is after like being filed and stuff, but they feel so much healthier than before. So honestly, like, I love Mary Ruth's. It is definitely pricey, so I can't afford to get them all the time. But like, when I was a partner with them, they were sending me stuff, and I was like, oh heck yeah, like, this is amazing. I love to put this out, like, especially when it's such good quality products that I honestly believe in. So I do need to order some more magnesium, because it, I used to take CBD to sleep at night because I have, I get insomnia from my anxiety, and it, even though I'm on the highest dose of Lexapro, it doesn't always help with the insomnia portion. And so insomnia, if you don't know, it's just where you struggle to fall asleep, stay asleep, things like that. So I can be dead tired and my mind won't stop racing. So anyway, I was taking CBD for it, and I noticed that like, I couldn't not take CBD to fall asleep. And then Mary Ruth sent me the magnesium gummies, and I started taking those at night, like before I go to bed. Like, I'm gonna take one right now. And that paired with my Dr. Teal's melatonin lotion. It's like, I have to have those at night. They help me sleep and stay asleep until one of the kids comes and knocks on the door or crawls in the bed and wakes me up. So I love these. I'm almost out, and I hate it. I hate when I'm almost out of things. But I definitely think I'm gonna have to add this to my October empties bag that I have. Not there, that's Tim Tracker, but hold on, that way, right there. but yeah, so I'm gonna go watch YouTube and probably text my mom, honestly. Vent to my mom about somebody stealing from me, because I have a hard time when things like that happen. It like really gets to me. And then feel bad because I didn't do my workout today, and I'm trying to lose weight because I gained like 10 pounds while Zach was back home on his mid tour. So yeah, I'm gonna think about, sorry, my back is just very bad at vlogging. Anyway, I'm gonna go do all that, and then I'm gonna fall asleep and then wake up and take Penelope to school and start the day all over again. So hopefully you guys had a wonderful Halloween, and I really appreciate you joining me for this vlog. If you catch it while it's being uploaded late tonight, thank you for watching, thank you for subscribing, and I genuinely hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!